Assassin's Creed Odyssey is finally a game on the PC which looks great in HDR. And if you can afford it, you even can play it in 4K. So what I mean by if you can afford it is, this is 4K at the moment in ultra details, and I'm talking about a 3-year-old game playing on a very high-end hardware, in my opinion, AMD 5950 16 core CPU, and yeah, the GPU is just a 3070, which is this one here, the Gaming Trio X, which is not a bad card because yeah, 3080 was not available at all, and 3090, to be very honest, is a joke in terms of performance and price. And yeah, 6900 XT or 6800 XT from AMD was sold out back then. So, and now I don't have money left, okay? So I have to play with this one. But again, this is, in my opinion, not a bad hardware. This is high end, because what comes after 3070 is a 3080, 3090. Forget 3090, okay? Don't buy this. If you have money like hell or crazy, yeah, go for it. But doesn't make sense if you have a 3080 or whatever. Don't go for a 3090. It's just, my opinion, crazy. Anyway, this is a 3-year-old game, and I mean, it looks fantastic. It really looks fantastic. Hey, where are you going? But we're talking about 50 FPS, and thanks God, G-Sync is activated on this screen, but still I can see stuttering, a very minor stuttering. So I found I was never able to get this game actually running stutter free, even with G-Sync enabled or FreeSync enabled or whatever you call it, or VRR, it's always stuttering. So, and we're talking about 50 frames. This shouldn't be, of course, not perfect smooth, but no, don't get me wrong. FreeSync, VRR, G-Sync is perfect smooth, but you, of course, you have very bad motion blur. It's not motion blur, but it will it will be not sharp anymore, of course. But I still can see that there's sometimes this minor stuttering, okay, this micro stuttering. As soon as I'm going back, going down to 1440p, and I put VSync in for 60 FPS, the game is very, very smooth, okay? But that's not the point, because I like to have, of course, 4K and G-Sync working, but unfortunately sometimes, I hope you can see it, this is not perfect. Yeah, let's say it like this. I saw better games, especially Red Dead Redemption 2 on the PC in 4K is working perfect with G-Sync, FreeSync, VRR, however you call it, because there was no stuttering at all. It was, you clearly can see it, that you end up with 30 FPS or whatever, but I never had those micro stuttering as I experienced in this game. Anyway, so let's take a quick look on my settings, and I already told you it's 4K in full details, so, but I'm going to change this actually to 1440p. Resolution modifier is 100%. Refresh rate, why is this just 100? Anyway, because I told you it's even better if you use 120Hz over 60Hz, even you just run the game in 60 FPS, okay, because of the lower input lag from the panel, okay? So we're turning on VSync again, and we are also limiting our FPS to 60, because with 1440p, we are in high-end frame rate range like 70, 80. Okay, it's crazy. I can actually show you this. You know why I should actually, no, go away. And we're turning off this as well. Here, graphic settings. Yes, apply the settings, please. Just forget this. And we're talking about, of course, HDR in a second, because HDR is really, really great. And as you can see, I'm using the ultra high settings, and I'm not going to change here something. So we're just jumping back into the game. And you can see now this is 1440p, and we're talking about easy 70 frames per second, which is, of course, when you target 60 FPS, much better, because it is really, really smooth then. But unfortunately, you can see, yeah, 4K versus 1440p, it is visible, okay? Yeah. Anyway, let's jump to HDR, because this is really great. And there is no doubt that I would play this game in HTHG over dynamic tone mapping, because this is the effect, or the HDR, what you get with HTHG when you have the right settings in the game. which we're talking about this in a minute, and it's just great. So dynamic tone mapping as always is overbright in the picture, and you lose a couple of details with the settings what I have at the moment, because as always I'm calibrating the in-game settings from the game for HGHG if HGHG is working. Some games it is not, okay, so keep this in mind, but I will tell you of course if I think just moving anyway if I think it's working or not, okay. So that at the moment is a very nice example on how much better HGHG or HDR actually is in a game, because SDR is fine, but you know, if you have a proper HDR implementation, and this looks really, really great to me, you have all these nice little details here on the stones, you know, where the sun comes, and this is also getting brighter, and of course with dynamic tone mapping as well. But to be very honest, it looks to me at this very moment dynamic tone mapping is also increasing the gamma, or I like to explain it like this, you know. With HGHG, I have a nice contrast between blacker levels or blacker areas and very bright levels. And dynamic tone mapping is mixing this a little bit too much, you know, because it is over bright in the picture, as you can see at the moment. So you lose a little bit of details and the nice contrast as well, okay? So, but let's have a look on my in-game settings. Okay, and here we are with the HDR settings, and I found something very interesting. Because usually, so default values, by the way, is 1120. And usually the maximum luminance for HDR is 800 for the LGCX, because we know LGCX is not capable of showing more than 800 candela. But if you do this, then you end up with a very bad HDR picture. I'm not sure if you can see this actually on your screen at the moment, but can you see this bad coloring around this sun or whatever it is? Very, very bad. And if you change this to 800, you still have sort of bad coloring around the sun, and not just on the test screen, in the game as well. So what I found is that actually the standard setting from 1000 is not destroying any details or not clipping any brightness or whatsoever. It's really the right setting for the LGCX. I'm not sure why. Maybe there's something not 100% right with the test pattern or whatsoever, can be. But anyway, 1000 maximum luminance, and also go up to 150, maximum 150, because 150 is already the edge, what I found, that you start losing details in very bright objects, okay? So 150, absolutely the maximum, okay? What I would recommend when you use HGHG for dynamic tone mapping, as always, you have to decrease the value a little bit, because dynamic tone mapping tends to over brighten the details, and this is then the picture what you end up, very nice bright HDR picture, and more than bright in my opinion for HGHG. So there's no need to use dynamic tone mapping, because the difference is anyway not that big in my opinion in this game. And this looks just fantastic. To be very honest, it looks fantastic. Finally a game on the PC where I really enjoy HDR. Wow. In this scene, the difference between HGHG and dynamic tone mapping is very, very minor. Almost nothing, to be very honest. Because if I'm changed this, you can of course see that dynamic tone mapping is getting a little bit brighter. Show me the sky, please. But that's it. And again, dynamic tone mapping is also changing the gamma a little bit too much. You know, you lose again the nice contrast between darker areas and brighter areas. So HGHG again is the way to go in this game. And it is more than enough bright, you know. Just have a look on this, what is stone? Have a look, HGHG and dynamic tone mapping off. And of course, dynamic tone mapping on makes it a little bit brighter, but you already lose all the details. So you have actually you need to decrease the paper white luminance, which makes the picture darker, of course. So just changing HGHG and dynamic tone mapping is not the right way, of course. You know, you need to adjust always the brightness in the menu as well. So you can't actually say dynamic tone mapping is much brighter. It's just not right, because you lose a lot of details here on those stones, which I can clearly see in HGHG. So again, very hard to compare, but for me, the clear winner in this game, HGLG. So time for a summary. 3-year-old games, brand new hardware, and I still can't play in 4K. Life sucks, and there's nothing what we can do. And that's wrong, because there are a million of options, of course, in the settings menu, what you can change as you like it. In my case, I rather go, or yeah, I changed it to 1440p and left everything on ultra high quality because I found it's much easier. It looks nice and it runs over 60 FPS all the time. So far what I found, okay? But of course, this is absolutely up to you and up to your hardware, because again, 3070 is not the worst graphic card. Cost me $500 more than the Xbox Series X, and it's the graphic card is not able to run this game in 4K. And also the CPU, of course, is very high in demand here, what you can see actually, sometimes up to 90%, which is crazy. So CPU is also a very high big component or factor in this game. But again, with the 5950, I have one of the fastest gaming CPUs. I still think even Intel released the new CPUs. This is not bad. Again, very high demanding game. Graphic is okay. Okay, so for the hardware demand, the graphic is okay. That's it. Okay, so I would not say that this is the best looking game I ever played. It is very nice with the details, with all the trees and stuff like that. Yes, but it's not the best looking game. Okay. But that's my own opinion, okay? So anyway, I would say that's enough for this video. Just put in a comment what you think about this game and what you think what I should do next. So in terms of games testing and games, in terms of comparing HDR test, whatever. I'm still waiting for the update for the TV, for the VRR brightness flickering update. And of course, as soon as I have this update, I will do an test. But so far, I just can wait, okay? So anyway, thank you very much for watching me, and if you're new to my channel, please do me a big favor, subscribe to my channel, I would much appreciate it, okay? Thank you very much, I see you next time, bye.